Hey guys, welcome back. What I have in front of me is saffron milk cookies. When I was in catering college or the culinary school in Mumbai, there used to be a cafe, in fact still is, next to the college, and they used to make these wonderful cookies. And one day I happened to be there while they were making it, and I got to see how it's being made, and I learned it. So these cookies are now being served in our restaurant along with our tea service, and I also make these cookies at home for the family. It's a huge favorite. So here's my recipe from my childhood of saffron cookies for you guys to enjoy at home. Promise you, they are absolutely Moorish and delicious. Ooh, delicious. To begin with, we add soft butter into a bowl. It's very important that you have the butter in a soft texture, not really cold and hard, because you want to cream the butter. So it needs to be at a certain temperature where the sugar can mix quite well. The caster sugar goes into the butter, and because the quantity is quite small, I would recommend you use a hand whisk. You don't need an electric whisk for this small quantity. Whisk it till the butter and the sugar mix and melt together well, and the butter becomes very nice and fluffy and pale yellow in color. This is a very important step, because once the butter has melted off, it can then take the flour quite well. Add a few tablespoons of milk. Now again, temperature is very important. So make sure that the milk is at room temperature and not cold. Whisk it till you get a smooth buttery mixture. Then goes in refined flour, a small quantity of salt. Salt is extremely important because it brings out the sweetness for the dish. Baking powder. And we're going to add one single spice, which is the cardamom. It's green cardamom powder, which gives a very nice aroma and a flavor to the biscuits. Custard powder, again a very unique thing to add into biscuits, but it works extremely well. And the next thing is milk powder. Now both custard powder and milk powder makes the cookie nice and creamy and rich. With a spatula, mix together all the ingredients into a bowl till you get like a crumble texture. You don't want to have a thick mass at one given time, but just make sure that the flour and the butter mixes to get a very nice crumbly texture. Now with your hands, you actually pinch in the dough and form a smooth dough, but don't need to knead it. It has to be firmly done, so it just blends together to form a smooth dough. Dust your tabletop or your silicone mat with some flour. Place your dough on top and again dust it with flour. What the flour does, it makes it more like a little non-stick. So when you're rolling it out, it rolls out very evenly and smoothly. Roll out the dough till almost 3/4 centimeter thickness. The edges will crackle, but that's perfectly fine because we just want the main part of the rolled dough, which we're going to shape and cut into circular shapes. So with a steel ring cutter, you can use a square mold or any other shape which you like. Cut the dough into the required shapes, and in this case I'm using a round ring mold. Any excess dough left behind can be utilized to make more cookies. Transfer the biscuits onto a baking tray lined with some greaseproof or a parchment paper. Arrange them very evenly. These cookies don't really swell and don't really bulk up, so they retain shape quite well. The next thing which is going to go onto the cookies is extremely important, because that gives a very nice flavor. It is actually a milk wash, and for the milk wash I like to add saffron into it. Now for this, heat up the milk to slightly warm and add a few strands of saffron, and as soon as the saffron hits the warm milk, it begins to release its flavor and its lovely color into the milk, and what you get is a light yellowish color milk with all the flavor of saffron. Brush this liquid on top of the biscuits, and do not forget that these saffron strands have to be added on top as a garnish, so when you cook your cookies or the biscuits, the saffron strands are visually seen on top, and it looks very, very nice. All the excess saffron milk is then poured onto the biscuit, literally giving it like a bath, and then drain out all the excess milk. Now what that does, the milk goes around all over the sides of the biscuit and adds flavor. These are cooked into a preheated oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 175 degrees centigrade till they are nice and golden yellow. And what you get at the end are wonderfully aromatic with saffron and cardamom, and the lovely color of the saffron which coats the biscuits on top. And because you have used the butter paper, they peel off quite well from the paper, take them off, either put them onto a biscuit tin or serve it straight away to your guest. I like to have them nice and fresh while they're still warm. Best enjoyed with a cup of tea. Enjoy.